Thank you, gamelan and kompang performers from Sultan Alam Shah School. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing 2012 Malaysian Book of Record holder and Brand Laureate Award winner 2014, critically acclaimed film star and singer, Crystal Lee.
When the sale comes first and the truth comes second, just stop for a minute and smile. Why is everybody so serious? Acting so damn mysterious. You got a shades on your eyes and your heels so high that you can't even have a good time. Everybody look to their left. Everybody look to their right. Can you feel that? Yeah. We'll paint it with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the, ching, ching. Ain't about the, yeah. Ba bling, wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Okay. We need to take it back in time. We're missing meters all unite. And it wasn't low blows in video hoes. Am I the only one getting tired? Why is everybody so obsessed? Money can't buy us happiness. Can we all slow down and enjoy right now? Guarantee we'll be feeling alright. Everybody look to their left. Everybody look to their right. Can you feel that? Yeah. We'll paint it with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the cha-ching, your chain ain't above the, yeah. Ba-bling, wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag.
We'll keep the price tag and take the cash back. Just give me 6 strings and a half stack. And you can keep the cars, leave me the garage. And all that is all I need, are keys and guitars. And guess what, in 30 seconds I'm leaving to Mars. Yeah, well I burn across the end, feed it for eyes. It's like this man, you can't put a price in the life. We do this for the love, so we fight and sacrifice every night. So we ain't gonna stumble and fall never. Waiting to see, just a sign of defeat. So we gon' keep everyone moving their feet. So bring back the beat, and everyone would say it's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the, cha-ching, cha-ching. Ain't about the, yeah. Ba bling, wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the, cha-ching, cha-ching. Ain't about the, yeah. Ba bling, wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Oh, whoa, whoa. Forget about the price tag.
Thank you.
Over the past 6 years, the Humanitarian Water and Food Award, or WAF Award as it's more commonly known, has been discovering and celebrating the exceptional pioneers whose projects concretely demonstrate how to address these critical challenges. The WAF Award works to give these pioneers the spotlight they so deserve and the partners they need so they can reproduce and scale these successful solutions at a global level.
Good evening, honored dignitaries, our special guests, and every beautiful soul in this room today. Welcome to the Humanitarian Water and Food Awards 2015 in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. I am Zainab, and here my friend Paul are going to host you for today's evening.
Absolutely. And next up, we have a very, very special person. This is the woman who founded the WAF Awards. She is the chief executive. She's really the heart and soul of WAF. Every great pioneer, every great entrepreneur, every great innovator has to go through many, many challenges. And this woman has done just that with WAF. She has powered through everything. This is one of the most extraordinarily determined, passionate, persistent, tenacious human beings I have ever met. And on top of that, she has a fabulous sense of humor. She's an expert horse rider. She actually coaches horse riding, if you ever want to learn horse riding. She's also a stunning dancer. I would like to welcome a truly extraordinary woman, Tina Lindgren.
I wasn't too sure if it was me you were introducing. Oh, God. So, Your Excellency, Madame Isabel da Costa Ferreira, First Lady of Democratic Republic of Timor-Leste, Princess Sama Sulu of South Africa, Her Highness Teng Kupu Teri Noor Sehan, Mr. Prem Rawat, Patron of the Humanitarian Water and Food Award, Tanshi Babji, Chairman of the panel, Your Excellencies, Ambassadors, Earth and Cable, founder of WAF Youth, our finalists, panelists, and distinguished guests. I am very happy to be spending this evening with you. It has been such a privilege for me to receive all of these award applications. And while the media was writing about all the terrible things that are happening in this world, I had the privilege to read one award application after the other and read about those amazing people, those amazing initiatives that are happening around the world, that sometimes we hear so little about them, and that's really why we have the award, so that we can get to hear more about you, so that we can spread a message of hope and solutions to everyone, not just experts or academia or the government. I feel it from inside that this is something I can do and that I should be doing. So it's just something I have in my heart that I want to do, and I feel so rewarded. I feel so graced. I feel so thankful for being able to do this work. I think that's what I want to say. Again, big warm welcome to all of you.
And now, introducing the first WAF Award finalists for 2015 from Nepal, ENFO, Environment and Public Health Organization.
In many parts of Nepal, the population depends on springs for its household and drinking water needs. Much of this water is heavily contaminated with raw sewage from nearby towns. Research shows that more than 80% of the drinking water supplies in rural areas are contaminated with bacteria like E. coli. and more than 10% of wells are contaminated with arsenic. In Nepal, every year, about 7,900 children die from diseases caused by dirty water and poor sanitation. ENFO is an organization dedicated to developing and promoting eco-friendly community-based approaches to solving water, sanitation, and waste management problems. The organization has developed a simple biosand water filter that is now impacting the lives of millions of people. This filter utilizes sand mixed with iron to remove bacteria and other harmful substances from the water. These filters are easy to build and repair and are made from materials that can be sourced locally. Each filter costs about $40 to $50 and will last for 15 to 20 years. Now, several hundred organizations have been trained to implement these biosand filters, which are impacting the lives of approximately 3 million people in 60 countries around the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce a really amazing young man. In fact, he is a very young man. When he was 9, he learned about factory farming. And as many of you will know, factory farming is both very damaging to the environment. It's also arguably the greatest single source of cruelty in the world. And he was so touched and moved and inspired by this that he decided that we needed a new law to change this. And so he came up with the idea of labeling food much more clearly so that when we go into the shops and we buy meat, we buy dairy products, we can actually see how the animals were kept. And he helped put together a coalition of four of the top NGOs in the UK to make this law a reality. And he went to the UK Parliament and he launched this law in front of MPs and the media at the age of 9. Since then, he has campaigned and done many extraordinary things. Last year, he founded the WAF Award in London. He has won every major award going in the UK for young change makers, for young social entrepreneurs. He's a Princess Diana Award winner. He's been recognized by Amnesty International, by the British Red Cross. He was nominated for the International Children's Peace Prize. And now, at the grand old age of 12, he is here today to speak with us. Please welcome Ayrton Cable.
One in eight people go to bed hungry every day, despite the fact we have more than enough food to feed everyone. And what makes this even worse is that half the food that we produce is wasted before it reaches anyone's plate. So at the age of 10, I didn't really believe this, and I wanted to see it for myself. So I went to Malawi and met this boy called Mapengano, and he told me that he only has one meal every day when I have three meals plus snacks, and that he has to walk 5 miles to school every day on an empty stomach. So I'm just going to show you the ITV Daybreak video quickly.
I don't know, it's hard to imagine, isn't it, that one in eight people in the world wake up hungry every morning, despite there being more than enough food, to feed the world's population.
Jonathan Swain is live in Malawi in Africa for us this morning. Jonathan, what have you found there? What can you tell us?
We travelled here to Malawi with a 10-year-old British schoolboy called Ayrton. He, after a school project, he wanted to come here to Africa to see what he could do to help.
He met 10-year-old Mapengano.
And is this your house over here?
Ayrton here has three meals a day back at home with drinks and snacks. Mapengano, though, survives on just a handful of maize every day.
At the end of his trip, Ayrton had a message for world leaders.
Mapengano is my friend. He suffers because of hunger. We need to change this. We need to end hunger.
People tend to think of young people as a future generation. But why can't we be the now generation and be a key part of changing things now? So I launched WAF Youth, and it was launched at Wembley Arena in front of 10,000 kids and in front of campaigning celebrities such as Richard Branson, Malala, and Prince Harry. It was also launched at International School Meals Day in front of the World Bank. The same 1 in 8 people that go to bed hungry every day are the same people that do not have access to clean and safe water. So when creating WAF Youth, we partnered with Global Action Plan and we created Water Explorer. And when creating Water Explorer, we focused on 5 key main issues, life values, which are integrity, commitment and care, awareness, responsibility and empathy, which make up the acronym ICARE. And if we had all of these 5 key life values, it would be the foundation to a truly peaceful and sustainable world. And as Gandhi famously said, be the change that you want to see in the world. So I'm just going to show you a quick animation which talks about Water Explorer.
Without water, there is no life. All creatures depend on water to wash, drink, and live. The problem is that the world's fresh water is under threat. Climate change, pollution, intensive farming, many things are damaging our water. In 10 years' time, scientists predict that 2/3 of the people in the world will find it hard to get clean water to drink. This isn't just in hot countries. Even countries we think of as rainy, like England, are worried about having enough water. So, it's time to take action. We need to make sure our world has fresh water for years to come. We're calling on you as water explorers to go on a very important mission to protect our valuable water. The first thing you need to do is to set up your team. Then, use our Explorer map to choose a mission and start taking challenges. There are 4 missions to choose from. Precious water, pressure water, secret water, and global water. Each mission has challenges to complete. Challenges can earn your team points and maybe even prizes. To measure your success, your team will be given a reservoir. As you earn points, you will see your reservoir filling up and plants and wildlife returning. Yeah. So what do you need to do to be a great water explorer? We have 3 top tips. 1. Lead the change. Great explorers are pioneers. They are leaders of change. A water explorer is for you, the students, to lead. There are loads of great materials to use to help you to lead the change. 2. Leave only footprints. The best explorers respect the land, animals, and even the smallest insects they find. Top teams will show great teamwork and put values such as kindness at the heart of everything they do. Look out for hearts that represent water explorer values. 3. Make every drop count. Good explorers capture where they've been and what they've done. This helps future explorers to follow in their footsteps. As you complete challenges, record what you've done and the water you've saved. You can do this with results, blogs, photos, and more. Look out for the Make Every Drop Count icon, so you know what to measure. As water experts working to reduce the threats to our fresh water, each year the top teams will tell a panel of water judges about their amazing achievements. Top performing teams from around the world will be in with the chance to represent their country at the Water Explorer International Celebration event in London. So, are you up to the job? Can you be a top Water Explorer team and make sure our world has water for years to come? Start on your mission today. Ready, set, explore!
So right now we have 11 countries participating in Water Explorer, out of which we have 700 schools and nearly 60,000 kids all participating in Water Explorer. Right now we have four finalists, which are South Africa, Italy, Spain and Turkey, all of which and all the teams have done amazing work. So last but not least, I'm going to show you a video.
That was a very feisty performance. I hope you all are enjoying yourself. There's such tight air in the hall. Give yourselves and them a round of applause, please. Thank you. I'm now going to call on stage a woman I caught off guard last night. I approached her and asked her a few things that I needed for today, but instead got something else in return. I was touched thoroughly to know that someone of her stature was so grounded to the soil of Mother Earth that when I went back home last night, I was like, wow, people like that feel this way too. It's not just us. I would like the Princess, Your Highness, to come on stage and facilitate the WAF Youth Award. May I have Paul and our brilliant young entrepreneur, Ayrton, on stage two?
Tarek Amakase? It's an honor, and I'm blessed, especially for Tina. We met in the beginning of WAF. It's a long story, but it's personal. But I'll tell you a little secret. I thought she was Michelle Pfeiffer because she had long hair and she can waltz in. So I wanted an autograph, but it turns out to be Tina. And she asked me for, like, I heard about her project, and I was interested. Even though I'm a princess, my grandmother taught me to be humble and not to take for granted that you're royalty and be spoiled, to give back to the community, because I don't just represent myself, but my country. And in our language, there's a saying that you are a human being by your deeds of other human beings. So in English, I would translate it like, you have to be good to others and have respect, because your kingdom can be taken any time. So you have to be humble. And I'm honored to stand here before you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Your Highness. Would you kindly reveal the winner of WAF Youth 2015, please?
Wow. The winner of WAF Award is Waybank Water Warriors from Waybank School, Secondary School in Durban, South Africa.
Whoa, thank you. Waybank School, where are you? Can you come on up, please? Where are you? Yay. Fantastic. Wonderful. We have three extraordinary people here. Please join us up at the front. So, we have a wonderful two-thirds size version of the WAF Youth statuette. Please bring it forward for Y Bank. Thank you very much. Maybe if you present it to Sharon and Umtabisi. Thank you so much. Wonderful. And we also have, I believe, a check for the school to help them with their extraordinary work of 1,000 euros. Wonderful. Thank you so, so much. Don't go anywhere. We need you. So, Ayrton, do you have any questions for them?
How do you feel?
Umtabisi, how do you feel?
I'm honored to be part of the WAFA project and to be a water explorer. What I feel is we have to encourage the youth to take care of the planet, because if you don't take care of it, you don't take care of us. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. And Sharon, do you have any thoughts?
Well, firstly, I'm very thankful to Water Explorer and WAF for giving us this wonderful learning opportunity. And I'd just like to say to the youth that anything is possible and that we are the pioneers and we should take charge of everything.
Yo, thank you so much. Thank you. I should tell you that Umtabisi is an amazing dancer, absolutely extraordinary. He's going to be an inventor when he grows up. Sharon is deeply passionate about healthcare and helping disadvantaged people. She's also a singer, a guitarist, two very, very talented young people. And lastly, but most certainly not leastly, many of you will know that Bill Gates is heavily involved in education. And what he says about it is very interesting, because he's been working in this space for a long, long time, is that the power of a great teacher is beyond our imagination. It truly is. So the difference that a great teacher can make to children is so far beyond what an average teacher can make. It just boggles the mind. And I'm honored, truly, to say that Silva Rani here is such a teacher. It's because of her that this very under-resourced school was able to do this in the first place. She has transformed this school. She started the food gardens there. She's a mentor to many of the children there. This is a school with 1,200 children. This is a very extraordinary woman. So please give a massive hand to three extraordinary people. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Thank you very much.
Congratulations to the students from South Africa. It's wonderful to see so much diversity in one hall right now. Exciting. Thank you, Your Royal Highness, Princess Amazulu, for facilitating this, Ayrton and Paul. Now, I would like to invite an internationally known singer, composer, and social activist who has used his talent numerous times to show the world his love for humanity and the environment. Everyone in Malaysia knows him, loves him. So I think everybody's going to be excited. May we please have on stage Mr. Zainal Abidin.
Royal Highness, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, very good evening. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So please, I'm not one of the speakers, neither the award winners. I'm going to sing for you. Can I sing for you today? If you know the words, you can sing along with me, but I'm sure you don't know the words because you are not Malay. But if you don't know the song, you can dance with me and you can clap your hand together with me. Can you do that for me? Music, please. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I've been in this industry for the past 35 years, yelling and screaming about water, about the rainforest, about the humanitarian, about people who are in need. Now I am 56 years old, I am still fighting for that. I'm not tired yet. I will go on and on and on through my music. You know, thank you. Hey, maybe you can clap your hands together with me. loosen up a little bit. Yeah, that sounds good. Jika malam tanpa bulan, apa cerita hey, gunung ganang tinggi melepasi awan, angin lalu meniupkan lagu ini. Pohon memerlukan air yang datang dari sungai. Semua ini janganlah engkau memusnahkan semua. Gunung ganang tinggi melepasi awan, angin lalu meniupkan lagu ini. Pohon memerlukan air yang datang dari sungai, burung memerlukan dahan ranting untuk besar, ikan memerlukan karang untuk kehidupannya. Oh oh, yeah yeah yeah. Pohon memerlukan air yang datang dari sungai, burung memerlukan dahan ranting untuk besar, ikan
Introducing the second WAF Award finalist 2015 from Haiti, Soil, Sustainable, Organic, Integrated Livelihood.
More than a third of the world still lack access to a toilet, and almost half has its waste dumped without treatment. In rural Haiti, a degraded landscape has long been impeding agricultural productivity, while inadequate sanitation has been breeding waterborne diseases. Since 2006, Soil has worked with community leaders to solve this dual challenge. The organization started by providing free public toilets. Since then, It has developed a sustainable business. The toilets transform 100% of human waste into organic compost for agriculture and reforestation. Over 300 households currently subscribe to this program, well on the way to the break-even point of 500 installations. Since 2012, Soil has sold over 75,000 gallons of compost. 2015 sales projections are over $20,000. Soil's consultancy provides support to replicate soil solutions. Currently, over 10,000 people participate in annual trainings and a national conference.
Earlier this afternoon, we had an incredible forum that was done for the WAF Awards. It was facilitated by Mr. Mark, who's from Paris, France, and Mr. Toke, who's from Copenhagen, Denmark. I'd like to call them on stage right now so they can tell us a little about the harvesting from the Impact Forum that was held earlier today. Mr. Mark and Mr. Toke.
Thank you very much. Do you want to start?
Yeah, okay, let's start. We have not really prepared because we just went through that day, and what we experienced for me was really a transformation. From most people coming to a conference, they were, I think, a little bit astonished to see that very soon we handed it back to them. Not that they would learn from the stage, but they would see and realize that actually they have something that they can share, something that they know and they can build from. But the choice is there. Will I recognize that I have this power, that I have this know-how already? Do I choose to know that and to make it in motion? Or simply, I'm waiting for somebody to tell me what to do. What was your experience, Toke?
100 people coming in the door, sitting in this room. And how can you measure the difference between being there to just receive, but to step up from being participants to becoming contributors? And I think in a period of 6 hours, it was a privilege to be with all of you because you came with a dedication already to make a difference. I think we were a room of people who had already decided to live more consciously and make a difference. If you want later on to just check out some of the things we worked with, we did took a little journey of looking at, from our own experience, what were the conditions that help us make a difference. So you can see some of the suggestions there. Education, having a vision, and being bold about creating awareness. Second part of the conversation, maybe you want to speak to that, Mark.
Yeah, the second part actually was interesting because we asked everyone to sit at tables of four and share. And the question was, after you heard the finalists, after you heard also the panel feeding back and saying, expanding the vision that was shared by the finalists, then we asked them, what do you see as the priority now so that we can expand, so that we can bring that not only in Haiti, in Nepal, in China and so on, but in the rest of the world? Not only in terms of doing this, but the awareness, the consciousness of making a change. And, well, a lot of priorities came back. Because after the exchange and share and so on, we harvested, we asked them, so what are your priorities? What touched me is three of them. The first one was collaborate. Don't stay alone. Don't stay in your corner. There are so many people, if you look, if you hear, if you just make a little move, there are so many people who want to make a difference, who want to make a step forward. So collaborate was the first one. The second one was change. We know it's not acceptable, so many of these conditions. So change. And Tina in the beginning said, we are working on solutions. We are not looking at problems. We are looking at solutions. And that really touched me. So the second thing was change. And the third thing was create. And even we would say, okay, we would say something like co-create. It's just like we have that capacity. It's just a matter of making a step. So, and then actually we
have a team for future. And if you want to see what those recommendations were, they're over there. But we also added saying, it's good to give recommendations, but will you also give an offering of how to make that possible? And some of those offerings were quite extraordinary because, first of all, one of the needs and recommendations was that WAF would establish itself permanently here in Malaysia. And there were then people both from government and business saying that they were ready to step up and help make that happen. So, a beautiful time. And now see the culmination from last year. And now we don't know what will happen, but more can take place. So, thank you.
So, yeah. And actually, when we were invited to host the forum, what to do? I mean, do we have like a panel with people sitting behind a table and lecturing and so on? Or do we give back the power where it belongs to everyone? And it's a challenge for us because we can give. But the main thing is to give in a way that it's taken. That what we offer, the space we create so that people feel discomfort to actually step in and step up in the fire of the real life, in the fire of listening to the heart, of making the difference. Because I feel in myself the difference. So we looked at it and we said, yeah, let's go and do something which will be interactive, participatory, and what do you think? What's your feeling after the day, Toka?
It's possible. I think the future, I really loved what Atten was saying, that it's not the future, it's now, it's us. And so, and we all know it, and now we can begin to act at it as we meet each other. So, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Introducing the third WAF Award finalist 2015 from the People's Republic of China, Truenscape.
China has only 7% of the world's farmland, but has to feed 20% of the world's population. Aggravating the challenge is a growing water shortage. 75% of surface water has been polluted, and 50% of wetlands have succumbed to urban development, affecting over 400 cities throughout the country. After channeling by the city of Liu Pan Chui, the Shui Cheng River lost the capacity to retain runoff and became severely contaminated. In 2009, the municipal government commissioned Truenscape to restore the river. The result has been Minghu Wetland Park, a water-based ecological infrastructure created on a site of deteriorated wetland, abandoned fish ponds, degraded cornfields, and garbage dumps. The park retains stormwater runoff from its infrastructure. Remediated by low-maintenance native vegetation, the water becomes the active agent in regenerating the ecosystem. The renewed ecosystem supports the continuing effort to restore Liu Pan Chui's former reputation as the Lotus Leaf City. Solutions like Minghu Wetland Park are vital for China's future.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would next like to introduce a very extraordinary individual. He was, in fact, the person who first conceived WAF in the sense of celebrating the very best food and water initiatives in the world. This man has been speaking about peace for over 50 years, in fact, since the time he was 4 years old. And in 2001, he founded the Prem Rawat Foundation. And at the heart of that was really seeing the link between the essentials of life, what we need to live, and the message of peace. And the Prem Rawat Foundation, over the years, has donated millions of dollars in grants and impacted more than 30 countries. And in particular, the Food for People program, which runs in India, Nepal, and Ghana, has an extraordinary impact on the poorest children there. And ladies and gentlemen, it is difficult to overestimate. I would say it is impossible to overestimate the impact of giving one square meal a day to children. For some of those, at least, it's the difference between life and death. And for all of those children, it is the difference between health and leading a life of sickness and disease. And because they're healthy and strong, they're able to go to school. And because they're able to go to school, they get an education. And because they get an education, they're able to grow up and lead prosperous lives and impact their communities. That is the impact of a square meal a day on a child. It is phenomenal. And this man is a brand laureate. It's a very rare honor. It's been won by Nelson Mandela, Hillary Clinton. He's also an ambassador for peace. So please join me in welcoming the truly extraordinary Prem Rawat.
Your Highness, First Lady of Timor Leste, Princess Zama Zulu, Your Excellencies, Ambassadors, distinguished guests. It's a great honor for me to be here today at the WAF Awards. I hope you're enjoying yourself. I think the performances have been quite exceptional, and especially the last one, two very intellectual people trying to talk about what happened today. It is true that we all have to make a difference. All of us. If we're waiting for the world to change, I'm afraid it's not going to change. If we're waiting for human beings to change, that's rather easy. Because there's 75 billion of them. And so the issue becomes, how did we get here? I know that they were talking about Tina not looking at the problems, but looking at the solutions. But I'm afraid I'm a pilot, and I do look at my messages and look at red lights and pay particular attention to the red ones. Because as the red lights are defined as continued flight after that red light comes on, can and will cause grievous harm to the participants, to the pilots, to the not only damage to the aircraft, but also the passengers. So if the world was an airplane and it had a dashboard, what kind of lights would be on? Would they be all green? Would they be all yellow? Or there would be tons of red lights flashing, going, something is amiss here. something is wrong. On one hand, and please, I don't know how to put this. I don't want to mince my words. And I'm not against anything in per se, but I see this duality and I don't like it personally. So whatever I'm about to say is not to harm anybody, not to hurt anybody, it's just what I feel. And on one hand, I see countries developing and trying to beautify their cities, building incredible structures, and on the other hand, there's devastation of the very resources that we all rely on. All of us. All of us. Even though we have divided countries and we have lines that say this is this country's board, this is what I'm bringing today. A lot of garbage that those guys dumped. I'm bringing it to your country. How much tax do you want to levy on this? No, it just simply takes it and brings it. A bird flies from one country to the other country without any regard for any of this. And of course, we know cockroaches. People tell me that I am a well-traveled person. And whenever I say that, I don't laugh, but inside I do, because I know those cockroaches have been doing a great job of it since a really long time. I'm just an amateur compared to them. They're professionals. And so I see this incredible duality that we have created. We weren't born with this. We have created this duality. We have created these differences. We have created these fractions. We have created these factions. And today, because of that, we have to live with the consequences of these. There was one word that was said today, and it's true. I mean, we need education in this world. But also, there is another difference that I would like to bring up. I'm a thinker, so I'd like to bring that up. And I would like to bring an example of Leonardo da Vinci. Leonardo da Vinci was not very well educated, but he was very well a learned human being. He asked questions. He said, why is it this way? Why does a mountain look blue? I mean, why does a mountain look blue? All the artists paint it green. But from a distance, why does a mountain look blue? And he said, oh, haze. And he started to paint haze into his pictures, which ultimately, and he always wanted to be an architect. But his name to fame came not as an architect, but as an artist and a painter. And all that he had learned about the human reality, or reality of perception, he was able to put in Mona Lisa. Because he asked questions. We're not asking the right questions. Most of the world is waiting for some angel to drop down from the sky and fix our problems. We're all just biding time. We're just waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. And how convenient. It's in all part of the world. Everybody is waiting. Every religion has one. Hang on, somebody will fix it. Everyone. So, what happens in the meantime? Resources are exploited. And nobody asks the question, how did we get here? Excuse me, why do we waste all this food? In the United States of America, they have farmland. They have taken land, fertile land, and converted it into literally a desert. and they bring on the water, and they try to grow the crops, and they have bugs. I mean, can you imagine through the evolutionary process, these bugs, right? These bugs, they have not acres and acres. No, no. They have miles and miles and miles and miles and miles and miles of the same crop they love. At the same, I mean, you know, it would be like somebody, a bug being born, and he looks out and he goes, I am in heaven. So, to kill these bugs, they have to make pesticides. So they make pesticides, and every year, the bugs are smart enough. We don't learn from the bugs. Bugs are smart enough, they adapt to the pesticides. So they have to make stronger pesticides. So they get to the point where the pesticide is so strong that it's killing the crop. So now what do? You come up with a new crop. Genetically modified, which is resistant to the pesticide. So they can keep increasing the toxicity of the pesticide so it can keep killing the bugs. And I'm like, this is brilliant. Very well educated, but very badly learned. No learning has occurred. Wars happen. That is a symptom. That is a symptom of unconsciousness. That is a symptom of a society all around the world saying, I would rather invest in weapons that will destroy us rather than invest in solutions that can save us. So that's brilliant, isn't it? And these people are very well educated. Some of them have double doctorates. But without a heart, a human being is incomplete. It doesn't matter how many books he has learned. There is a saying in Hindi, a bookworm does not become intelligent. Even though he lives in the books, he eats the books. I mean, he doesn't just read them, he eats the words. But that doesn't make him wise. What makes us wise? What has to happen? This issue comes up many, many times. What about something for the youth? What about this generation? And when I look at that question, I'm like, oh, wait a minute. What is the point of this generation? The people who make the decisions, they're all much older. And you're not including them because they have to be included. They are the generals. They are the colonels. They are the presidents. They are the staff that lives there. Even as the presidents come and go. They are the ones who say, no, Mr. President, you can't do that. We have created the systems. And now we are reaping benefits, yes, and also reaping the consequences. Things are going to get worse and worse and worse. I live in California, and they say, everybody says this, we're running out of water. And I said, excuse me, have you looked around California? It's a desert. Do you know what the definition of a desert is?
It has no water. It never had water. It doesn't have water today. It won't have water tomorrow either. And the population keeps increasing and increasing. I said, it's not the water. Don't blame the water. Blame the misuse of what little water the desert has. So people are misinformed. The whole idea of WAFA, it's going to be called WAFA because we have added another category. This was standing before for Water and Food Awards, but now it's going to actually stand for Water, Air, and Food, or Water, Air, Food Awards. Those are three very important things for a human being to exist. And the innovations, this is to recognize those people who make the little innovations that have huge impact, that can have huge impact, and it is to encourage those people. You know, the fact of the matter is, we don't know how bad our religion, and our caste, color, clothing, thoughts, ideas, beliefs, wants, needs, forget it. Next time you see a human being, give yourself a quiz. What did you see? And keep at it till the day your answer is, I saw a human being just like me. We're made out of the same thing. We're made out of the same thing. All of us, six things: hydrogen, oxygen, carbon, calcium, nitrogen, and phosphorus. Somebody, you know, the day I was given the title Ambassador of Peace, I went back home and I looked at the person who was there, and I said, now you're going to have to call me Your Excellency, I'm an ambassador. I was just kidding. Because I know. If somebody calls me Prem Rawat, if somebody calls me Mr. Prem Rawat, if somebody calls me Your Excellency, if somebody calls me, hey you. Or sometimes, my wife just calls me, hey, listen. So, my name is also, hey, listen. Do I change? I am the same person. I was born, I am alive, and one day I have to go. Those are the three segments of my story. But it's not about the day I have to go. This is what everybody is infatuated with. I don't really care about the day because I don't even have to make that appointment. It's all about, whilst I'm alive, what difference can I make? How can I make my world? This is my world. This is my world. How can I make my world a better place? How can I bring smile to people's faces? And peace is just one part of it. Peace is very essential and very important, but also being aware and conscious about what you're doing in this world is also very, very important. Is the problem so big that it cannot be solved? Absolutely not, because every human being has the capacity in them to understand and to change and cause that change to happen. If we're talking about moving the orbit of moon, I think that would be a little bit more difficult. If we're talking about moving the sun a little bit further away, I think that would be very, very, very difficult. If we're talking about changing the ocean to fresh water, well, I think that's going to be a little tricky. But we're talking about something that is very changeable. Those same human beings in them carry, every human being, in fact, and this is what I have been saying of late, that every human being, 50% good, 50% bad, exactly 50%, not 49, 51, exactly 50%, every single human being, 50% terrible, horrible, nasty, mean, stupid, to quote my grandson. and 50% good. What's the difference? What do you perpetuate? What do you water? What do you enhance? Enhance the good, good will grow. Enhance the bad, bad will grow. So far, we have been enhancing the bad, not the good. We have been telling people what they cannot do. We have to start telling people what they can do. We have to increase their understanding. We have to tell them. We have to empower people. We have to give people choice. That's your power. This is what Mark was talking about. Choice. Toke was talking about choice. I go to prisons. I see the inmates. What's the difference between, and I was saying this yesterday, I said, what's the difference between them and us? We're free, we're not in prison. What's the difference? What's the difference? I mean, they have a private toilet. They get 3 square meals. We have to go, we have to decide. They don't have to decide. They get 3 square meals, a very good security. We have to pay for ours. They don't need an alarm clock. We all do. What's the difference? I'll tell you what the difference is. They don't have a choice. We do. Do we feel empowered by our choice? Do we feel empowered by our choice? Do we feel like I exercised my choice today, I saved water. I exercised my choice today, I didn't waste the food. How does the food get wasted? Do you know that it's so little that has to be done? Don't buy that orange unless you're ready to eat it. Because when that orange is sitting on that table in that bowl and it turns green on the other end, it goes. Whew. All you have to do is don't buy it till you are ready to eat it. This world, and I will keep it very short here. There's a little story I would like to tell. There was a guy, and he had these monkeys, and he loved his monkeys. And he took care of his monkeys and he fed them very well. And he just had a beautiful relationship with his monkeys. The monkeys loved him as his father, and it was just great. Every day he'd come and they'd watch. He'd give them food. And one day he fell on hard times. So he fell on hard times and he went to the monkeys and said, I'm really, really sorry. I'll only be able to give you 3 buns in the morning and 4 buns at night. And the monkeys went crazy. Started screaming, yelling, protesting. And the guy said, okay. I'll give you 4 buns in the morning and 3 in the evening. And they became so happy. You know, it really reminds me of us. We just put something a little bit a different way and we get, yes! Einstein said, keep doing the same thing and expect a different result. That is the definition of lunacy. Dare I ask, do we keep doing the same thing year after 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 year? And is anybody here expecting a different result? Oops, you better not have said yes. So, that's how simple it is. That yes, people can be awakened. And the whole purpose of the Prem Rawat Foundation, which is the big core here for WAFA, it really is about very, very simple solutions. Extremely, extremely simple solutions. Because what happened in Ranchi, undeniable. What is happening in prisons, peace education program that is being brought out by the foundation, changing people's lives. Whose? Not only the inmates. Excuse me, not only the inmates, but the wardens. And all the security officers as well. Them watching the transformation in those inmates has actually brought on a transformation in the entire prison system. There's hope. There's hope. Prisons have become a commercial enterprise. They have. With a law called three strikes and you're out. Are you playing baseball with people's lives? Really? Really? I mean, justice is supposed to be blind, but not headless. Here you're chopping off the head of the justice. And so, this is just how I feel, because I see these things. And I see that if all this unconscious behavior is going to go on, the efforts that are made by these wonderful people, I mean, how far is it going to go? Because there is a wall, and that wall is a very unconscious wall. And yes, that is why it is so important to include everybody. Government isn't bad. Government isn't bad. It's when the greed gets into the government, then the greed is bad. Not the governments have to be taken away, but the greed has to be taken away. I mean, it's just like when you go to a doctor and you have a pain. Say you have a pain in your kidney, and the doctor goes, I can fix this no problem, I'll just kill you. And you won't feel the pain. I mean, the patients will go, you know what, I'll take the pain, but I want to be alive. So you don't have to kill the governments. You just have to kill the greed. Take the greed out of the system. And how do you take the greed out of the system? By replacing it with a better greed. A greed for peace. A greed for fulfillment. A greed for prosperity. When we start to understand that that's what we want, that that's our power. Our power isn't machine guns. Our power is compassion. Our power is passion. Then the world, it won't take much to change it. And this is coming from a person who has witnessed it in the prison system. In the most hopeless place. And if not most hopeless place, there can be a change. A change that goes to the extent where there was a person in Greece. And he had joined. He was in the prison. He had joined the peace education program. And then his date came up and he was released. After he was released, guess what he did? He went to the warden. And he said, can I come back and finish the peace education program? That's people empowerment. And yes, it is possible. So it is really wonderful to see the interest of so many people in making a difference. And we are here to acknowledge that difference, that change that people want to make, and to offer our sincere thanks in terms of these awards to support them, so that more and more people will continue to make the little changes that make a big difference. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Prem, so much. And now, We're at that part of the evening where we find out which of the three really extraordinary finalists have actually won. And it's worth bearing in mind that these are three of a very, very extraordinary short list and an amazing long list of organizations. So we're talking about a truly elite group of organizations in the sense of their quality. And I say that because we only have one envelope. So I'm going to keep you in suspense for a little longer.
May we have the finalists on stage? From Nepal, Team N4, Mr. Bipin, Mr. Ash Kumar Khaitu, and Mr. Rameswar Adhikari. Our finalists from Haiti, the organization Soil, with Dr. Sasha Kramer, Ms. Erica Lloyd, and Mr. Baudelaire McLoy. And the last finalist from China, Project Turnscape, Dr. Kanjian Yu. I really hope I pronounced your name right.
Wonderful. So,
Miss Whaley, please Whaley, come on stage.
Yes.
My apologies.
Also from Turnscape, China. Thank you so much. So, I was saying earlier that we only have one envelope, because usually when you have three finalists, that means that you have three results, right? You have a third and a second and a first. The jury thought about this, they debated this, they considered this for a very, very, very long time. It was truly, truly splitting hairs. And in the end, they just could not decide whether to award a second or third place and just how to split these three really extraordinary organizations. So we have one winner, and it's in this envelope. And so, Prem, I wonder if you would be kind enough to do the honors, please, and let us know who that is.
Be my pleasure. In my opinion, the day you were born, you were a winner. And with a heart of gold like you have won many times over, and you will continue to win every single day. So, for Soil, Haiti, and for ENPHO in Nepal, and for Turnscape China, I'm happy to announce it's a three-way tie.
Whoa. Amazing.
It's a three-way tie.
Congratulations.
So you did all win.
You did. They all won. Thank you. Fantastic. And so,
I like happy endings.
And so we even have three copies of this really prestigious and beautiful statuette for each
Congratulations.
Of the three winners. Thank you very much. And not only that, we have three checks for each of the winners. This is to support and further their extraordinary work. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Wonderful. Are you all happy? We're one world, we are one people, and there's one winner. We're all winners. Congratulations. I would like you all to tell us something, a part, an element of your venture that really touched you, that was so important. How do you feel about doing what you do?
Absolutely. Turnscape, would you like to start?
Well, thank you. I think today I really been educated by Mr. You. what? I missed you. Yeah, hey you, yes, hey you. You listen, Mr. You listen. I think first one, we have to understand that we are in a serious situation. We are at a crisis. The second, we need hope. We certainly hope that keep we doing that. And the third, we have to do it, act little by little. A small change will eventually make a big change. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. And Soil from Haiti, would you like to share?
Nano Soy Ndi, merci.
In the name of Soil, I tell you.
N'a continué travail dans tout monde là, n'a partagé connaissance nous, expérience nous avec tout monde là pour avancer vers l'avant.
We're very happy because we're going to continue our work not only in Haiti but around the world.
Merci en pile.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And Info from Nepal, would you like to share, please?
Firstly, thank you. Good evening and namaste, ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, I thought like I am quite educated, but I changed my point of view by today. So I need to learn more and more. So I would like to express my sincere gratitude to WAF Award for recognizing us, that effort we put in for creating access to safe drinking water in rural communities in Nepal. And this will also increase our work horizon. And I'm very honored, we feel very honored to be sharing this platform with our finalist friend from China and Haiti. So it's our honor, and I would like to request all of you to support in our initiative, and also wish you good luck for your efforts to make this world a better place to live for us and for future generations to come. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Wonderful. Thank you all. Congratulations. Congratulations. Thank you.
Wonderful. That was beautiful to go through such endeavors and to be the one to bring changes around the world. It takes a lot of heart and blood. Now, as Mr. Prem Rawat mentioned earlier, WAF is going to become WAFA. Why? How many of you all in this room can hold your breath for over 10 seconds? Maybe a few? Okay. 15 seconds. 20, 30, you must be a swimmer. It's swimmers must be the only ones who could actually hold their breaths for longer than 2 minutes. But someone like me, 5 seconds is the furthest I can go. And as you all know, as we walk out of Sunway Resort today, and not just today, it's been there for quite a few days, 2 months, I guess, since August, since I last recalled. It's jokey. The smog outside is bad. The haze is literally killing everyone. Only a few days ago, I found out that weather conditions like these can reduce a human's life a year or two. I don't know how long I live. I don't know if I can make it beyond today or tomorrow. I mean, I'm not a pessimist, but I'm just saying, let's be realistic. And already to shorten like a year or two out of my life, I don't want that happening. I'm not even married yet. So yeah, I want to reach there at least. So yeah, I mean, it's pollution. And who is causing it? We can say, yes, it's climatic change, weather, this and that. And you all know what's coming next. It's us who has caused it. And it has to be us to be grateful to the earth. It lets us breathe. It gives us oxygen. We pump blood because of oxygen. And if we aren't the ones to fix it, I don't think, like Mr. Prem Rawat said, there are no angels coming to save us. So Paul, please.
Absolutely. And so next year will be very exciting because it will be the very first year in which there is a winner of this brand new category which Prem Rawat mentioned. So WAF is now water and air and food. Here's a little sneak preview video of what's in store.
Smog, haze, carbon emissions. The issue of air pollution is not new. It's a vicious cycle, a cycle that needs our collective attention. Are we breathing just the air we need, or are we taking into our system pollutants that are harming us? It is against this backdrop of compounding problems that Water and Food Award has decided to create a new award that will acknowledge, as well as spur, initiatives to bring about changes in the way we value the fundamental commodity of our existence, the air that we breathe. In 2016, we will introduce the WAF Air Award.
Wonderful.
There we had it. So now we are going towards the final segments of our evening. Those are our sponsors, so I thank all our sponsors for making this event happen. Thank you, our dignitaries, our royalties, our excellencies, and all our guests today who have made this evening happen. I would like to make one request with all our invitees today. When the show is over, when we're ready to go home, I would like you all to be seated so our dignitaries could exit the hall first without any mumbo-jumbo at that little door there.
Absolutely. Before we move to our very, very, very final segment, can we just have back on stage all of our finalists, everybody who has appeared on stage today. So we have the finalists, Tina Lindgren, all of our extraordinary performers, Ayrton, everybody, and of course, Mr. Premier White, if you wouldn't mind rejoining us, please. Thank you very much. Wonderful. And so in close, we are being joined by a man that you all know and you all love. Please welcome once more Mr. Zainal Abidin to sing Hijau.
Thank you again. I've been singing and yelling about this song, and people in the rural area in Malaysia begin to understand what is humanitarian and environmental conservation all about. I am glad, and this vision is still go on and on and on and on.
Well, I'm not a crook. I burn everything I've got.
I'm sure some of you know the song. You can sing along with me. I would like to invite all the school children from Alam Shah to be on stage with us. The committee member, people who is involved to make this event very successful.
Bumi yang tiada rimbang, saumpama hamba, biar dicemar manusia yang jahil ketawa. Bumi yang tiada ukan kehausan, pasti lambat laun hilang duniaku yang malang. Apalah gunanya kematangan bila di jiwa kita masih lagi muda dan mentah kulihat hijau. Main gambar-gambar siapa yang melihat dikala kita tersadawa mungkin kan terlewat yeyana.
I know you know this song, you can sing with me.
Dewasa ini kita saling merayakan kejayaan yang akhirnya membinasakan. Apalah gunanya kematangan bila di jiwa kita masih lagi muda dan mentah kulihat korupsi, agresi, obsesi, diri, iya, polusi, depresi, buku, begini, korupsi.
Everybody. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for having me here tonight. I'll say thank you very much. I'll see you some other time, some other place. Thank you very much. Congratulations to a wonderful and successful event. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. There are way, 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 way too many people to thank for this extraordinary event. Some of you are in this room. Many of you are scattered all over the globe. It's been a phenomenal effort, and it's really come from the heart. It's just been such an act of spirit. Thank you all so, so much. This has been an extraordinary evening. Thank you.
See you all in 2016.
Thank you. Okay. Do you have some music?
Ladies and gentlemen, kindly be seated until Her Royal Highness and our VIP guests have exited the hall. Thank you.